Hello there, year six. Welcome back to my channel. We are going to continue our science studies. And our next topic is still mountain ranges. After the Trans-Danubian mountain ranges, we will continue our journey and we will visit the northern part of Hungary. Have a quick look at this map here. So after the Trans-Danubian mountain range, similarly positioned mountain range is the next one. From southwest to northeast, you can see the different parts of this mountain range. But before we start analyzing all the parts of this, let's have a look at the tasks we started already in your workbook. Page 98, look at task one, please. I would like to share a special kind of map with you. This one. There you can see the rivers of the region, and we have four rivers mentioned in our workbook on page 98 in task one. And those are as follows. Ipoly is one of them, which is in the northern part coming from Slovakia. So the name is written up here, but basically, the river just goes all along, this part. So this is Ipoly. I'm going to draw an arrow here. Yeah? So Ipoly is this one. Danube is much easier. That is a kind of westerly border of the northern Middle Mountains. So please write Danube there in your book as well. But the river is just coming down all the way to the south. Next one is Bodrog, which is also here on this map in the northeast of Hungary. So you can find the name here. Please find it on your map. It's right in the corner. There's a kind of triangular shape between Tisza and Bodrog here. So I'm gonna circle this one. And finally, Tisza. So that is just going down there all along to the south. So you can write that the name, so it's here, it's also here. So these are the major rivers, but there's a similar task on page 100, this one. And please have a look at that, because we also have rivers there. Zagyva, Sajó and Hernád. Zagyva is right in the middle of Hungary. The name is written here. And they put a circle there, not the best location though, but you can just still write there. So there's this circle there and we can write letter A in it because this is Zagyva. Then Sajó is the next one, which is right here, as you can see, in the Borsod Basin, so Sajó. And this is B, so I'm gonna write a B here. Okay, and the last one is gonna be Hernád, which is also in the same region, and that is C. I'm gonna put there letter C. So A, B, C, from west to east. So these are the rivers. Okay, now, because we would like to learn about a mountain range, it's really important to check the parts of the ranges. So this is why we need a map once again. And let's see what are the smaller mountains of the northern middle mountain range. Please open your textbook as well now so you can follow all these. Yeah, on page 102. And 103. So let's go back to our map. This time we need the smaller regions of the country. Let's see whether I can just make it a bit bigger. Great. Yeah, like this, we can see all the important parts. So let's start in the west. The northern middle mountain range starts in the west here. I'm going to draw as well. So the Burgeon Mountains is the first one, which is a volcanic range. It was a volcano. Now it's not active, luckily. Then comes the highest andesite mountain range of Matra. And between the two, there's a smaller basin, so a deeper area called Nógrád Basin. So volcano number one, volcano number two. Then Duke Mountains, which also had some volcanic actions here and there, but it's mostly limestone with a lot of caves and dripstones inside. In the north, there's a smaller plateau, Karancs-Medves. There was volcanic activity here in this region as well. This part is not in your book though. Then comes Cserehát, which is a hill range basically, not so tall. And between Cserehát and Bükk Mountains, there's another basin called Borsod Basin. In the north, there's a World Heritage Site with a lot of limestone and biggest cave in Central Europe called Baradla, and it's right there in Aktelek, and the name of the mountain is Aktelek Karst. The word karst comes from Slovenia. Then comes the Zemplén Mountains. Sometimes atlases refer to it as Pokaj-Eperjes Mountains, but I think in Hungary it's more well known as the Zemplén Mountains. Once again, volcanic hills, volcanic ranges, lots of really specially formed, triangular shaped classic volcanoes in the neighborhood. If you go to Sátor Alja Újhely, you will see these little volcanic hills. The name Sátor comes actually from this thing that the neighboring hills all look like little tents because they were tiny volcanoes. They are not active either. If we go back to Matra Mountains, we can just put here big cross because this is the highest part of Hungary. The highest peak is Kékes. There were even hot springs and geysers in the neighborhood here in these mountains. But again, these geysers are not active any longer. So these were the basic parts of the northern middle mountain range or northern Hungarian mountains. Please have a look at your activity book now or workbook, page 100, tasks, no, not 100, page 98, task 2. And on this map, you need to symbolize all the major parts of the northern middle mountain ranges. Okay, I think one section is not symbolized here on this map, and it's in your workbook, and the mountain range which is not there or not here on this map is called Cserehát. So I'm going to put here a C and an S to symbolize that for you. So in your workbook you need Burgeon, Cserehát, Matra, Bükk. These are all there. Then Aktelek Karst, Zemplén Mountains. Plus, there are the two basins. The big Roman one shows the Nógrád Basin. There's one more Roman number that shows Borsod Basin, the two deeper areas. Okay, and the rocks are very simple. Burgeon volcanic rocks, Cserehát limestone and volcanic, Matra volcanic, limestone mostly, Aktelek limestone, and Zemplén volcanic stones. So you need to write about these as well in task 3 on page 99. If you listen to the video footage carefully, of course you can stop it anytime when you need to stop it, and then you can just write down the important information about these. Then let's see some nice photographs of the region, and let's explore together what these are and how they are connected to the northern Hungarian mountains. I'm trying to show you the images by using my iPad screen. So let's start with this stone. This is a grayish stone, the end product of volcanic activity. And it's in the Imatra Mountains. The next one, basalt, the Hungarian name is basalt. Again, you can find this in certain parts of the northern middle mountain ranges, mostly in the northern part of it near Karancs and Medves. Really hard stone. They used it for building roads. The so-called cobblestone or macskapő is basically made out of these types of rocks. Oh, these are the geysers I mentioned to you. They are not active anymore. You know, they could just, hot waters or hot springs could gush up from these. And nowadays, unfortunately, they are not there. These are just part of post-volcanic activity. So it's a true sign that the area was an active volcano or volcanic region in Imatra. This is the Cserhát Basin. In Cserhát, you can find parts of volcanic activity and lots of limestones as well. Bükk, full of limestones, lots of caves and dripstones. Aktelek, the entrance of the famous cave Baradla in Aktelek. The mountain is called Aktelek Karst. And these are the dripstones inside. Stalagmites, stalactites, I hope you can still remember these, and some columns, dripstone columns. The special tent-shaped mountains of Zemplén are here near Sátor Aljaújhely, which is a smaller town in the region. And finally, an image of the Borsod Basin. I just wanted you to see that the basin area is a tiny bit lower than the hills, not that tall. Of course, in the region, because there are plenty of mountains, precipitation is really important, an important factor, and the amount of precipitation is higher than on the Great Plain, of course, even though there's less and less rain as we go closer to the northeastern border, because we are getting away from the Atlantic Ocean. But it's still important to remember these. Maybe one more thing. The area is famous for some spas, so thermal waters are important, and these can be used for medical purposes, like in Mezőkövesd, or Bükszék, Barátfürdő, Miskolc, Szapolcs. So see, these are some of the famous wellness paradises where you can go to with your family, hopefully soon. And you can try these out. Okay, so if you checked the pictures with me, then hopefully you can read the text now on page 102 and 3 in your book. So please read the paragraphs. After that, the homework task in your workbook will be the things I mentioned earlier, plus page 99, task 4, this one, page 99, task 4 in the workbook, and a special kind of graph analysis. There's a special bar chart with some information concerning local weather in the region on page 100 in task 6. This is not really about something difficult, like difficult knowledge. You just need to analyze the different data here, and you need to write short answers there on the lines. I hope you can do it, and we can check these later on when we have our Zoom lesson. So keep up good work. Don't forget about the homework, and please send me these. Take a photo of them and send them to the usual email address when you finish them. Thank you. Bye-bye.